Hello, fans, and welcome to this latest edition of Hockey Talk. I'm Bob Crawford, and joining me on this edition is Whale assistant coach Pat Boller. And, Patty, it's been kind of yin and yang for the team. You had a perfect weekend 2 weekends ago, and then you didn't get a win in a 3 games in 3 nights last weekend. I'm sure from a coaching perspective, you're searching hard to find a way to be a little more consistent here.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, we have a young team, and it's been kind of a little bit of an up-and-down year from that standpoint, but you know, just got to keep learning from the mistakes and correcting them. And I think in the long run, it's going to be beneficial for us.
Now, I'm sure when you really get concerned as a coach is when the same mistakes start getting repeated again and again. But when you talk about learning from mistakes, do you feel like this group is making progress in that area?
Yeah, absolutely. It just seems some of the things we do, something different morphs each weekend. So, and obviously some guys are making some of the mistakes, you know, again, but you know, it's not so much of a reoccurring event that, you know, it's worrisome for us. But, you know, like I said, in the end, I think it's going to be beneficial because we'll just keep teaching. And you know, by the end of the year, hopefully we'll have it all straightened out and we'll take it all the way to June.
And in this lockout affected AHL, there's a lot of top-end players in this league, and you've got some really high-end guys too. When you look at what Chris Newberry's done over the course of the season, Chad Kalorick lately, Chris Kreider's still getting his game going, I think. But do you feel that your top-end guys have done a decent job of trying to carry you a little bit?
Oh, without a doubt. And when you have a young team like we do, the onus is going to be on the older guys to kind of take a little bit of the load so the pressure's not on the young guys. And our guys have done that for sure. And it's not just been Chris and Chad, you know, Siegs and our D, Colley and Pyatt and Gilly, all those guys have chipped in as well. And Talbs as well. You know, I mean, he's a guy that third year and he's played well and he's kept us in a lot of games too. So that's been very helpful.
Yeah, I think that was one of the interesting questions about this team coming into the game is that Cam Talbot had such a great finish to last year. He might have been the best goaltender in the playoffs, at least while you guys were in there, and would he be able to do it over a full season? And you always knock on wood when you talk about goaltenders, but so far so good.
Yeah, without a doubt. I mean, to me, he's proven himself to be an NHL future goalie, and you know, he's doing all the things that we need him to do. He works hard in practice. He's committed. He's battling, and you know, it's great to see that.
And when you build from the net on out, obviously the next key ingredient is the defense. And I think people forget you had such a huge turnover on that defensive unit. You brought in some really good players, but when you lose the likes of a Wade Redden, who hopefully will be back at some point, Pavel Valentenko, guys like that, those are big holes to fill.
Well, without a doubt. And, you know, one of the biggest things is a learning curve for those guys as well. You know, playing within our system, we do a couple of things differently than most teams. And, you know, it's part of the process.
And when you look at the upcoming schedule here, you're in a crunch of home games here. I shouldn't say a crunch. It's an opportunity, 7 out of 8 on the home rink. And I'm sure you probably looked at that stretch of the schedule as an opportunity really to improve your position.
It's definitely a time of the year where we need to make some hay and get things going, get some wins at home, and have a positive feeling going into the Christmas break.
And for you this year, it's pretty much the same role, but a new title, assistant general manager. How are you wearing that so far?
Yeah, it's been nice. You know, just something that, obviously, great gratitude to Glenn and Shoney for giving me the opportunity to do the stuff I do. And, you know, slapping that title on there is obviously very, you know, very exciting.
Nice to be able to boss Jernander and Buku Boom around too, right?
Yeah, I don't do that.
That's Pat Boller, Whale assistant coach. Patty, always great to talk to you. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Hawk.
Thanks for being with us. Enjoy the game.